America has a long history of invention and resilience. Just decades after winning independence, we're constructing our first paved highways, transporting goods on the C&O Canal, and building railway networks. As one of the 100 largest cities in the nation, Frederick is at the center of many American innovations. Over 100 patents are registered by county citizens throughout the 1800s. But of all such discoveries, perhaps the most life-changing is Jacob Weller's invention of the friction matchstick. March 31st, 1842, an unusually blustery day. Fireplaces in many homes are working hard to hold back the damp bite of night. A fire ignites in the chimney of a home on Court Square. Very quickly, flames spread to a dozen surrounding mansions and the county courthouse. Independent Hose Company responds from just a few blocks away and is able to contain the fire, but the event frightens Frederick's citizens. Just weeks later, that fear grows when a fire destroys one-third of Hamburg, Germany, the country from which many locals originated. What would happen if all of Frederick was destroyed by a single chimney fire? And how would we rebuild? The creation of a locally based insurance company suddenly becomes a topic of intense discussion by community leaders, most assertively by George Engelbrecht.
They were really acting on behalf of the community. Fire was a great threat. Insurance was available from out-of-town providers. However, it was far too expensive for most. The big challenge was coming up with a way to make it affordable.
After much study and debate, the group develops a plan to establish a cooperative enterprise, with each policyholder being a partial owner in the company. Funds raised through premiums are used to offset claims and pay company expenses, while any surplus is invested. With the Articles of Incorporation approved by the state of Maryland in December 1843, the Mutual Insurance Company of Frederick officially goes into business. Its 12-member board vows to live up to the confidence entrusted in them and to
be faithful in the execution of claims,
carry out a business philosophy of low conservative growth, limit underwriting to high-quality properties, and to invest surplus funds wisely.
By the end of 1844, the company is providing insurance coverage for more than 300 homeowners, local businesses, churches, and universities, with policyholders identified with fire marks issued by Frederick Mutual.
This strategy, these values of conservative decision-making and faithfulness to our policyholders, combined with innovative thinking, enabled the company to remain resilient and profitable, especially through economic hardship, natural disasters, as well as wars. It was Frederick Mutual's dedication to customers that led to the evolution of new product, ensuring what was important then, such as seasonal crop harvests, individual household furnishings, changed to protect what is important now, offering the equivalent of comprehensive homeowners insurance.
Today, Frederick Mutual is a $20 million a year company with 22,000 policyholders and an enviable A-minus rating by AM Best. It is the ninth oldest insurance company in the country, but in the midst of a major reinvention of itself, it is in some ways among the youngest.
Frederick Mutual Insurance Company is a generalist. What that means is we underwrite a broad range of insurance, and this is intended for homeowners as well as small commercial businesses. It makes us very attractive to independent agents throughout the region.
Through recent expansion, we now serve four states and D.C., an area that represents a $14 billion market. And we've developed a new competitively priced product that we believe will respond to that commercial market. We're also among a limited number of insurance companies nationwide, large or small, that is fully digitized. With these and other provisions in place, Frederick Mutual has the potential for exponential growth in the coming decade.
While so much has changed in the insurance industry, it's the fundamental values and strategy that our founders put in place that served this company and our policyholders extremely well for the last 175 years. bringing these same values forward will serve the company very well for another 175.
And that is American Genius.